Point it back, point it at him, right there,
Got him, look at him, right?
What the fuck? What the fuck are you doing? Stop, you
What is he doing? You're so pretty in that dress, but I look bad, so I gave you everything I ever had, even my sweat, so mood is our shitty, like North Carolina weather.
What's good, everyone? You're watching Have You Heard? We are with Glaive today in his hometown of Hendersonville. He's gonna give us a little tour of the area. Thank you so much, bro.
Of course.
All right, first stop.
My school.
In my whole world, cry, I live in monochromatic. In my last girl's sight, I'm over dramatic.
I come here every day at 7 o'clock sharp.
It's a good story.
I have detention every day for the rest of the school year. So I just have to stay every day after school for an hour or two. Because I have so many absences. My teachers were like, you're gonna fail if you don't come after school every day for an hour. So every day I sit in a silent room.
We're doing a race. I don't really know how it came to be, but
so we're doing.
I'm tying my shoes, I don't wanna lose. It's mad embarrassing if I'm the youngest one here and I lose the race. I'm wearing these, they're not really racing shoes.
Well done. I haven't done anything athletic in almost 3 years.
D-tier one.
But like by this much. On the record, it was like that much.
It was literally like in Cars when Lightning McQueen had his tongue out. And Dinoco and...
What was the other guy's name?
Chuck.
Chuck.
Was you getting solo food?
I have no idea. I've never gotten on the bus before.
Like...
Alright, kids. Fire extinguishers up front. Please keep your arms and legs in the aisles. Or not in the aisles, in your seats.
Keep them in the aisles,
actually,
man.
For today's ride, we can keep them in the aisles. Where are your favorite spots to drive with your newfound mobility?
No, I don't drive anywhere. The only place I drive is here. Yeah. I don't like driving at all. It's like not a good thing for me. I'm not good at it. But I've gotten into like 2 car crashes since I started driving, and I haven't been driving for very long. It's kind of embarrassing.
You think you're gonna go to prom though?
Imagine. I'm thinking about it.
Yeah.
I wonder who I could get to come to my prom.
Yeah, who would your dream prom
date be?
Americo, Eric, George Lopez. Will you please go to prom with me? I rock with the bus. As Blueface said, used to ride the bus down. Now I wear a bus down.
Here's the next location, sir.
Okay. Normally what I would do is I go to school and then go to my house.
Alright.
We're gonna go home. Ready? It's gonna go like this. Ready?
She's in a red beret in a nice cafe. The Versace shades.
What was your like initial reaction when you showed her anything musical?
Oh, I loved it right from the beginning. His very, very first stuff was it was a little darker. I'm like, are you okay?
Okay, so I posted my story. I'm like, I don't know how to do any of this. What does any of this mean? This guy replies to my story. He says, "You are dumb as fuck. Good thing you got music or you'd be a bum on the side of the street." I could literally post the most difficult math equation of all time. And they'd be like, "I learned this in fourth grade. Are you stupid?"
This is it, man.
Wow.
All right.
So you see, we got that right there.
Wow.
The bookshelf. See, the chair is gone now.
Huge.
Some crazy stuff, right? I think this might be the end of everything. This was it. I think the cover art is me standing like right here and like shaking my head like this. And that's it. Fancy stuff, right?
Person thought you like lived at Cypress Grove.
Yeah, a lot of people think that that's like my home. Like, this, it makes sense. Like, right?
Yeah.
Name the project after the street that you lived
right
on. But I was driving home, and this I took a picture while we were driving back, and it just like all the rest were blurry, but this one just had Cypress Grove. Like, you could see it, and it was like very clear. And I was like, that's such a cool picture. So originally that was the cover art, was that picture that I took, but it was like over time it just like was kind of a crappy picture for the music. So then I came back out here with my mom and a photographer from Asheville that I'd met like a few weeks prior, and we just took like a lot of pictures right here. And then that was the cover art.
What happens? Joel, where's the hair? Where are we headed to? We are getting into some goats. We're gonna tap into some nature.
We're getting into some goats?
He's getting into some goats? What does he mean by that? What is he trying to say? What is getting into some goats?
Let's run that back.
The first time I was in the New York Times, the photographer made me come here at 5 a.m. and take pictures, like over there.
Really?
It was so cold, I was so tired, but it turned out really good. Well, we took pictures like right over there.
We wanna go see some goats, hopefully.
Let's do it.
I thought they were way closer than they are. I was like remembering them being like you walk in and they're right there, but that's just not the case whatsoever. Last time we were here, I took some like music industry people here and they were just like, it was a culture shock for them. Like when you grow up in a city and everything is like a city,
for it to be like this is like completely different, like very open, very sprawling.
It's real live goats.
Real live goats. They're not even just on the screen anymore. They're real. They're real in person.
They're just not on Discord.
Right, exactly. You would never guess, right? You'd always thought the goats were just things that they made up for Discord, but no, they're real.
Joel, tell us about our trek up to here.
It was a bit tiring after our race, but no, I think the real goats are the friends we made along the way.
Go. Oh, I see a goat. I see a goat
right
there.
Let's go.
Oh, my. Oh shit.
Please don't mimic him. Holy. It distresses me.
You're gonna say something? I was waiting for you to say something.
Thank you guys so much for watching. This week we are in Hendersonville with Glaive. That was a little hometown tour for the boy, but I hope you guys enjoyed it.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Come here, man.
This makes me feel really good.
That's the right height.
Sometimes I shouldn't text you. You act just like my ex do. You know I try my best to catch you. You wanna be so fluffy, so it's still.
Best song of all time. You have 5 seconds. Five, best four, song of all time. Three, two, one.
Oh, there's a song called Drake and Chill by Pierre Bourne. It's on The Life of Pierre One. It's so good.
Best song of all time. You heard it here first. Debate in the comments.
Great time at Glaive House.